Coros entered the market some 2-3 years ago with their Pace, which is more of a triathlon watch, and then followed up with the Apex, their premium multisport watch. Now, I had a chance to talk with the CEO at the ISPO, and he was quite happy to find somebody who would also be able to report in German, not just in English, and who is doing quite a bit from a real use perspective with sports watches. So, with their support since early this year, I have had an Apex to try out. I've collected quite a bit of data with it, done quite a bit with it. It's all still a bit of an issue because I'm trying out a bit too many watches nowadays, and with the OHR and sleep tracking, I'm trying them out so much that sometimes it has been hurting my skin, and then I don't wear any, and so it all gets mixed up badly. But among all of that, the Apex has become pretty much the most comfortable and has been the one which has been causing me the least issues. And well, if you had told me a while back that you wanted to get into sports watches, into producing them, I would have said, well, I can think of a few things which we are missing. First of all, actually, a watch with great battery life, and that does not cost 500 euros upwards, more like 800, like most of the standard sports watches with GPS now do. But I would have been very, very insecure if there's any chance of you surviving it. Coros is still here, seems to be doing ever better, and for good reason, because their watches are pretty nice. I have just been publishing, I still need to say it like that, the Vienna City Marathon video and then the discussion of the tracks, and as you can see there, well, all of the watches had some issues, the Apex among them, but they were all quite usable to know where the run was. I have used the Coros Apex alongside other watches in the mountains. I have used it quite a bit on my usual runs here. So we will have quite a bit of data to look at. Most of that will be ending up on timeandtours.com, on my blog about sports watches, outdoors watches in actual use and how they perform. But we do want to have a look at impressions of it. And impressions are, well, at the Vienna City Marathon, I ran with it. I went there with the watches at 100%. And the Coros Apex after the 4 hours... The Coros Apex after the 4 hours of running still had 91% of battery. I had recharged it and gone to Florence, where I also did some running, also with it, also very interesting GPS tracks we will have a look at. And, well, yesterday I went running in the rain here. I went running in Florence twice. I have been using it for most of that time for my daily tracking. And the battery is now at 66%. It is unbelievably good at that. For a new contender, where you would think they should have some growing pains, actually, they are doing at least as well as the established companies we have, which all still would need to bring some more stability and some more features into their current premium watches. So, wow. Next video we will get to, maybe you'll want to subscribe, is a look at the daily watch faces and tracking and everything that the watch just shows. So my usual menu bits, guidance through the watch, and then there will be a few more bits on the performance in different situations, not just the Vienna City Marathon, which should be published when I publish this video. And I will also have to add the Apex to my navigation series, all about navigation, which you can find on my YouTube channel, because, yeah, navigation has come to it. Yeah.